I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you how to do an army print nail. Yes, we're doing camouflage. So we've got a tip. We're going to work on a tip today. I've got three colours. No, I tell a lie. I've got four colours. So I've got three sort of normal, what we call flat gel polish colours. So these are all from the normal colour range. This is a khaki colour, and I know somebody who calls this khaki. Khaki to me means a totally different thing.
When we did the other video before, people thought you were saying cocky.
No, khaki. Not cocky. This is definitely somebody I know says khaki. And khaki in England means like what a baby would do in their nappy.
Or diaper.
Or diaper, yeah. That's khaki. So you go to the toilet for a cack. Yeah. Khaki doesn't look anything like khaki, and if it did, I think you need to go to the doctors. So we've got that colour. That looks nothing like poop. And we have this one, which is a paler version. A bit brighter. And then I've got a dark grey. You could use black if you had black. You could use totally different colours if you wanted to. But today we're going to stick with the traditional camo colour. Well, I've also got from the metallics range, I have this colour, which is gold. Beautiful. Beautiful. We're going to start, we do need to layer these colours, so we're going to start with the khaki colour. This may have a name because the polishes are being named. I don't know what it is. Well, maybe by the time you watch this video, it will have had a name. Who knows? I'm only going to do one coat of this. You could do two if you want to, but I feel it just needs one coat. Look at that for coverage in one coat. The reason I'm doing one coat is because I do not want to make it too thick. Imagine if I did two coats of this and two coats of this and two coats of this and two coats of this. We'd have like a whole mountain of polish, and we never want to visit Polish Mountain again. Then we're going to use the paler of the khaki colours. Dampen dish. I'm going to splodge a little bit out there. You know how I like to be a bit messy. And I'm going to use a short flat brush. You could use a detail brush, it doesn't really matter. We're just going to do these random shapes. One thing that you don't want is you do not want them to look like drips, else you will look like you're doing a drip design. So they're just quite sketchy patterns, really. Do different sizes. And you can see you only need one coat of this. It covers really well. I'm going to pop that into the lamp, cure that. And now I'm going to use the dark grey. Just going to blob a little bit there on the bottom of my dampen dish. And now you're going to overlap, because that's what the camo does. It overlaps onto the other colour. And I think that's why it looks kind of cool. So don't think you've got to go in between those markings that you've put on already.
That would look too uniform.
It would, yeah.
And nature is not uniform.
No.
You're like putting a zebra in a forest.
Yep. You do not need to be a really good artist to do this at all. If you've got, you know, a bit of composition, then you'll be good to go. And then what we're going to do is we're going to top coat over with the Urban Graffiti top coat. I'm going to cure that. Now you could leave it like that. But because this is army inspired, we are going to do the ranking little mark things. I have no idea what they're called.
Ranks.
The ranks, yeah. And they have like little stripy things.
Yeah.
So we're going to do that. To do that, we've got the hollow stencils.
So these are going to be like fabulous
army
fabulous,
sergeants.
Yes. Fabulous sergeants.
Fabulous. Attention, Sergeant Fabulous! So, right, I'll show you two different ways that we can do this. You can use the actual sticker. Now, I find this is a little bit tricky because you've got to be really careful, because as soon as you peel it off, it starts to do this thing. And it, because all this is sticky, if they touch each other, it'll just mess up the whole thing, and I find it really tricky, really, really, really tricky. So go really slowly catch a monkey, and then it's stuck to my nail. Oh my God, that's it. I'm gonna use tweezers now for a moment. That's it. So we're going to concentrate on those three stripes at the top. And you've got to be dead careful. Once it's on, you're fine. Once you've got part of it anchored on like that, that's fine. Because can you see how it all starts to move? And you see how this part's stuck together now? And it's quite difficult to unstick. The other way that I was going to show you is to use the centres from the hollow stickers and to individually place your stencils on. So you'll need to put four of these on.
And what rank's that?
It's Sergeant something or other. Sergeant Fabulous, of course.
Sergeant Major.
Sergeant Major! I don't know. My cousin, who's in the army, is probably shouting at me now, telling me I should know these things. But I really don't. You could just use the stickers, you know, with them being so fabulous. Fabulously holographic.
I thought that's what you were doing.
No, I've just shown you what I've done. Remember?
I didn't quite get it. I thought that was the holographic.
No. You could just use the holographic like that. Maybe we should.
That's what I thought you were
Let's
doing.
Let's do it. So we'll just put them three on.
No, hello. Do it how you were
going to
do it.
No, I quite like it now. We'll do this one the other way anyway, so we can show everybody out there the few different ways to create this army-inspired design.
Fabulous.
This fabulous, darling. It's so fabulous. What we're going to do for this one is we're using the hollow parts. Now this one, we've sort of changed our mind on what we were doing, and we're using just the actual holographic strips. So now we're going to take one of the stars, because it's so fabulous, and we're going to pop that just above the lines at the centre. I like that. High five, Adam.
The only thing is, I think you'll get spotted in a forest with the hello.
Yeah, with the hello. Like, not going to be invisible with that on, are you? So what I'm going to do with this one, where we've used them like stickers, I'm going to top coat that. And then I will take off the excess after. By that, I mean these little bits here. I'm going to file that off after, because I want the gel polish top coat to secure that on really well. Really, really, really well. Make sure you get in between. And I'm going to pop that into cure. The one with the stickers, what you're going to do to tidy up that is just drag the file down the edges and it will get off any of that excess. It'll just file it off. I'm going to do the same on this side. I would definitely advise for you to give that another coat of the top coat to seal in all those edges. Now, because I put my fingers on that, I'm just going to clean that up a minute. And I'm going to top coat that. And then we're going to crack on with the other army inspired nail, just to show you these two different ways that we can do it. That's that one completely finished. Check out the hollow. You know, Sergeant Fabulous there. On this one, because I only want 1, 2, 3 lines, on the third line up, I'm going to cut. So 1, 2, 3, I'm going to cut there. And then I can peel off what we don't want. That makes room for the star. So this star that I have here, we're going to use that. Now I don't need all these other stars. So I'm just going to cut out what I want. So it's this star here. That's the star that I need to be completely stuck down. And then what we're going to do is use the gold metallic. Very thinly. And just brush that into the stripes. This is Sergeant Goldfinger. And now we're going to do the star. The thinner you apply the metallic, the quicker it will dry. So don't forget, this will air dry. But we're going to pop it in the lamp just to make it dry that little bit quicker. You like? Obviously we need to seal that in, so we're going to use the Urban Graffiti top coat. Pop that in the lamp, cure that. So we've got two different versions there. We have the one with the hollow stickers.
Sergeant Fabulous!
And then we have the one with the metallics, Sergeant Goldfinger. So it's just a few different ways that you can create a camo effect inspired by the army, the fabulous army that we have here in England, and so do America and all around the world. Keep it up, good guys, because we love good guys. We don't like the bad guys. The bad guys can go away. There you are, guys. I hope you enjoyed that army-inspired nail design. If you did, give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel because it is awesome and it'll be the best thing you've done in a long time. All the products we've used today in this video are down below in the description box. Check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll see you all in the next video.
Did you really just do that?
Yeah, really? I really give the camera a thumbs up. Give us a thumbs up, don't forget to subscribe. We're in the army now. Oh, we're in the army. Hey, guys.